I got to get back to Amazon. I want to bring in Small Business Administrator Linda McMahon. Ms., welcome to the program. Great to have you with us.
Thank you very much, Stuart. It's good to be with you this morning.
Open-ended question, is Amazon bad for small business?
I don't think so. I think that Amazon has provided an opportunity for a lot of small businesses to get their product into the marketplace. You know, Amazon kind of can be looked at as big box stores first were when they came into communities where they're going to put everybody out of business, and they don't. They can have short-term impact and even some long-term impact, but those small businesses, I think, that are innovative and creative are utilizing more online services to distribute their product, and Amazon's kind of paved the way for that.
Would you listen to demands to rein in Amazon? They have really upset, shall we say, the bricks and mortar retailers and various other industries, a lot of opposition to them. Would you support any call to just rein them in a little?
I am certainly in favor of free market, and I don't look to rein in anyone unless there were, you know, really unfair trade practices that were going on and that sort of thing. But it's a free market enterprise. Amazon is growing leaps and bounds. I mean, there's even talk that they're going, that they could merge, you know, with satellite companies to distribute more of their video. And so Amazon is a really big player across a lot of different marketplaces. But I think that, you know, online opportunities for small businesses have given many small businesses the opportunities to get in business.
We hear this morning that the White House plans to have a tax reform draft in place before August. They're going to give it to Congress and say, pass this thing, get on with it. You're smiling. You support that?
I sure do. I certainly do. And I think small businesses that I've talked to around the country are really anxious for tax reform. It's one of the reasons that there was so much optimism in the marketplace from small businesses, why they were looking more to start or to grow their businesses, and they're really counting on tax reform. So I definitely want to see that put in place, not only for small businesses, but for everyone.
But it's the most important thing for small businesses. If you file under a subchapter S, you've got a subchapter S corporation, you're paying personal income tax rates, get that down, and you've got a huge business for small business, a huge boost for small business all across the country. That is, I think, is that the single biggest issue for you?
It's the one I hear about the most. That and regulatory reform. I can tell you that regulatory reform has been just as big an issue for small businesses almost as tax reform. But the idea that those you know, sole proprietorships or LLCs or sub-S corps, you know, could have a 15% tax rate, you know, they're ecstatic about that possibility, even any reduction, even if it didn't get to 15%.
Linda McMahon, Small Business Administrator, thanks so much for joining us today. We really appreciate it. Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Okay.